Bali, the island of the gods. Unofficially called the island of the gods, Bali is a gorgeous blend of pristine beaches, rocky coastlines, vibrant temples, relaxing spas, and happening nightclubs. In the last two decades, Bali has become a hot pick for travelers across the world. Ubud, the cultural capital of Bali, is home to several eclectic temples and historical sites. For laid-back travelers, Bali offers pristine white waters and sandy beaches where you can stretch out with a tropical cocktail in hand. For adventurers, Bali has a host of exciting activities like bungee jumping, paragliding, snorkeling, scuba diving, and hiking. Travel. The best way to get to Bali from India is to take a direct flight to the Nagura Rai International Airport in Denpasar. There are flights to Bali from most big cities in India, so finding one that suits you shouldn't be a problem. Visa. Indian tourists heading to Bali need not apply for a prior visa, as Bali offers visa on arrival for 30 days. This can be further extended by another 30 days should the need arise. Currency. Remember to carry Indonesian rupiah with you when you travel to Bali, because that is the national currency here. There are loads of places with money exchange services in Bali, but make sure you pick an authentic one. During your travel, try to carry smaller denominations for easier transactions. Best time to visit. The best time to visit Bali is from April to October, when the weather is balmy, 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. Since the place is a sunny paradise from April to June, that's when you see the most tourists. August to November are ideal for sightseeing and other outdoor activities. December to March is generally considered off-season due to heavy rains. Accommodation and travel costs reduce at this time, making it perfect for budget backpackers. Where to go? Ubud. Once in Bali, you must definitely visit Ubud. It's the cultural hub where you can find glorious local craftwork, jewelry, and textiles. Ubud also has ancient temples, gushing waterfalls, entertaining music and dance shows, and the sacred monkey forest. Nusa Dua. If you're a beach bum, you'll fall in love with Nusa Dua. Nusa Dua has the best beaches in Bali, and here you can go for swimming in the sea or try activities like snorkeling. Make sure you pick a certified operator when you try your hand at water sports. Nusa Dua is a huge draw for couples and makes for a great honeymoon destination, since the beaches here are relatively uncrowded. Kuta. The city of Kuta ushered in the modern era of tourism in Bali, and most travelers love this town over others. It is home to the most happening nightclubs, beach parties, and lounges, and hence has the most crowded beaches. Seminyak. Seminyak is another upcoming tourist hotspot in Bali. Some of the best things to do in Seminyak include lounging by the pool at Potato Head Beach Club, having coffee at Revolver, horse riding along the beach, and scuba diving. Seminyak is a little more upmarket than Kuta, so you want to give it a miss if you're traveling on a tight budget. Accommodation. The wide variety of options available makes Bali suitable for couple getaways, family vacations, and even holidays with friends. You can also find suitable accommodation that fits into your budget easily. Bali has some hand-picked luxury hotels that offer relaxing spas, azure pools, and the warmest Balinese hospitality. Viceroy Bali in Ubud and Grand Hyatt in Nusa Dua are prime examples. If you're looking for a comfortable mid-range hotel in Bali, the Biasa Ubud and Villa Costa Plenty come highly recommended. Bali also has a plethora of budget options that'll help you soak in the charm of the place without having to spend a fortune. These include Green Garden Hotel and Bali Agung Village. If you prefer going the homestay way, you should also check out Umahod and Utu Homestay. What to eat? Don't leave the islands of Bali without feasting on local delicacies like pisang goreng, mee goreng, and nasi goreng. These Balinese dishes use a variety of spices blended with fresh vegetables and meat, usually seafood, to create a symphony of flavors on the tongue. 5 to 7 days should be sufficient for you to enjoy the best of Bali and come back with a host of memories. The allure of the islands will make you want to return again and again. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. Don't forget to let us know your thoughts in the comment section and share the video with someone who'll enjoy it. Subscribe to our channel to keep fueling your wanderlust.